Are you filming?
Yeah, no, you can just go.
Okay, thanks.
You can just go.
Wow. Cool. Thank you. Thank you. Aqua.
They love the dress. They love it. Thank you. Di depan tuh ada cuma.
So that was 4 days of hiking around the island of Madeira. These were all 4 different hikes. I was in Madeira for 7 days, so I obviously did more than just hike. And I'll share more in a later video on the island that hopefully helps anyone who wants to visit Madeira themselves. But for now, I want to go over some details of the 4 hikes that I did. The first hike was the Pico to Pico hike. This is by far the most popular hike in Madeira. And you can see why, with its dramatic landscape, dark mountain tunnels, and at times you're literally just walking above the clouds. Traditionally, the hike starts at Pico Arero, where you can even catch the sunrise before embarking on the hike, which is recommended. This is a point-to-point hike, not a loop, so most people usually decide to hike back after reaching Pico Ruivo. If you decide to hike back, then it'll take around 4 hours to complete the entire hike. Alternatively, if you don't want to hike back, you can head down to Achada do Tecera, which is a bit easier, and you can get a taxi back to Arieiro from there, which is what we did. Our second hike was the Lavada do Moinho. This was a Lavada hike, very common in Madeira. A Lavada is basically these channels made to transport water from the northern part of the island to the southern part for agricultural reasons. The trail itself was quite narrow, and for our hike, quite wet as well, but the weather did clear up, and it just goes to show how quickly weather can change in Madeira. So as always, do bring some rain gear. The hike takes around 2 to 3 hours to complete. Our third hike was the Lavada 25 Fontes, and I'll say this, if you're only going to do one Lavada hike in Madeira, then this should be it. It takes you to the Risco waterfall as well as the 25 waterfall, or 25 fountains I should say, but there are many route variations in the area. We did a route which included a 800 meters long tunnel at the end, super dark and spooky. Definitely recommend using a flashlight with this one, but overall a great hike that will take you around 4 hours to complete. I'll be linking the all trails map I use for this hike and all the hikes in the description box below, so check that out. And our final hike was the Ponta de São Lourenço hike. Also a pretty popular spot, lots of people when we were there, and also a bit windy, but it did have some nice coastal views, and I do recommend making the last incline up to the small peak to get a nice view of the dragon tail of the island. It'll take between 2 to 3 hours to finish the hike. So yeah, overall, Madeira is made for hiking. Many different trails to do, lots of incline. It's a beautiful island, reminds me of a tropical version of the Faroe Islands, if I have to be honest. But unlike the Faroe Islands, Madeira stays pretty warm all year round, which makes it a great destination for escaping the European winter. We are getting into peak season now for travel in Europe, so I'm expecting to be making more trips to different places in the next few months. Anyways, as mentioned, I'll share more about my Madeira trip in another video, but for this video, that's pretty much it. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below. This is Alan, and thank you for watching.